Hello people from Second Humanities. Today we are going to have the review. Remember, we have some of these topics: be like versus look like, for personality, objective to practice for the quiz, simple past versus past perfect also. Present perfect, when do we use it? It's the duration from the past until now. For example, he has been a teacher since 2020. We're going to use it also for an event in the past at an unspecified time. She's been to Paris. I have seen that movie. Repeated events in the past until now. We have had 4 exams so far this semester. The formula is have plus the past participle. Another use is change over time. My niece has grown a lot in the past year. And uncompleted actions that is expected to happen. They still haven't arrived. Yet, we use it in question and in negative sentences. We use yet, we are expecting that something is going to happen. For example, have you finished your work yet? I haven't seen the new James Bond film yet. We use one instead of repeating a singular countable noun. Is this your umbrella? No, mine's the big one, the big blue one. We can also use it for a plural noun. I think these best poems are his early ones. For example, be like versus look like. Don't confuse them. What is your brother like? We do not say he likes ice cream. No, no. We say he's a kind and smart person. What does your brother look like? Sorry, what does your brother like? He likes ice cream. That's correct. Be careful with these two things. Not like, you're talking about be like. Like, look like, and be like. We use like to talk about tastes and preferences. Look like to describe physical appearance. Be like to describe a person's character or personality. What does Alex like? Alex likes football. What does Alex look like? He's tall, dark, and handsome. Who does Alex look like? He looks like his father. Zero conditional, we use it when we're talking about facts that are generally true and don't change. If you leave ice in the sun, it melts. We have the condition and the result. The condition and result, both of them using the present simple. The first conditional is when we are talking about something that is possible in the future. We use the condition and the result. The result is going to be written with will. The condition with the present simple. Exclamations. We use exclamations to express strong feelings or emotions. Use to give a command. We use it also after interjections and in informal writing. Stop. Sit down. Help! Boo! They shouted, get up! You did a great job! Here we have more. Amazing! Tremendous! Gosh! Okay, let's continue. The simple past versus the past perfect. Remember, simple past is a finished action in the past. The past perfect is an action that is finished before another action that is finished in the past. Examples: I cleaned my house yesterday. She had lived in London for 3 years when she decided to buy her own flat, for example. So here you have another example. He had cooked dinner when she arrived. What happened first? She had cooked the dinner. This is something that happened before another action in the past, that is, in this case, she arrived. This is the past perfect. The present perfect, we use it to talk about non-specific actions in past or experiences. I have seen the Eiffel Tower. The past simple, this is specific. I saw the Eiffel Tower in 2007, for example. What is the form of the simple past and the past perfect simple in this case? Remember, I'm combining the three tenses: past simple, present perfect simple, and past perfect simple. The simple past, I spoke. the past perfect simple, I had spoken. I need to use the auxiliary verb had. We have some exceptions when we add ed. When the letter is e, only add d. For example, love, love. After a short stress vowel, the final consonant is double. For example, admit, admitted. Final is always double in British English. Not in American English. Travel, travel. Final L, I'm sorry, final L. After a consonant, final Y becomes I. Worry, worried. Okay, here we have some same words for the simple past, first, then, past perfect, already, up to, then, before, that day, after. Be careful, after is only used as a singular word for past perfect. If it is followed by a subject, the verb means that one action had been completed before another action in the past. A good leader, we need to have a good leader, or we need good leaders to help guide us and make the essential large-scale decisions that keep the world moving. Think about this. Good leaders can change the world, and you can be also a good leader. 10 characteristics of a good leader. Integrity, ability to delegate, communication, self-awareness, gratitude, learning agility, influence, empathy, courage, and respect. What is a concert? A public musical performance in which a number of singer or instrumentalists or both participate. These are some of the words that we find in a concert: gig, stage, dance floor, roadie, the band, sound check, early bird tickets, backstage. Musical genres, hip hop, classical, jazz, country, opera, soul, rap, rock, pop, Latin. Performance, orchestra, band, group, choir, lyrics, solo, composer, guitar player, concert, festival, singer, album, dance, microphone, conductor. Thanks for your attention. Excellent people from Second Humanities. Bye-bye.